Hello guys and welcome to Mark Shrimp Tanks. Today is shrimp versus pollen, and this is also going to be a first on my channel. This is my own product. Okay, so what we're going to do today is shrimp versus pollen, and on the side here you will see a breakdown of all the ingredients that are in pollen. Pollen is an absolutely fantastic food, especially for baby shrimp, because it dissolves in the water. It dissolves into tiny minute particles, right? So what we're going to try and do here is I'm going to try and capture this on camera. So I have to pick a part where I think it might stay still. You see this little bit of swirling here? Okay? And then I'm going to put a few grains of pollen, and hopefully one of them will float, because if one of them floats, you'll see what this does. You see it? Can you see the trail that's coming off the pollen? Let's try another piece over here. Let's try and keep it in the circle. You see it? Can you see the trail coming off that little bit? It's almost like a comet with the little particles of pollen coming off. And these little particles of pollen will spread around the entire tank, okay? But what else I've also done with this, guys, is my own pollen contains beta-glucans and montmorillonite clay. Okay, we all know the benefits of montmorillonite clay, and you will also know the benefits of beta-glucans. Specifically with this type of beta-glucan, what happens with it is all food has a moisture content. You'll see that even on dry foods. If you look at packets, there is a moisture content, and the moisture draws in any other powder that you add to. Okay, so I've added powder to this food in the form of beta-glucan and montmorillonite clay, and it is sucked into the food. It's absorbed by the food, okay? So this is kind of like a superfood for baby shrimp. The adults will eat it as well, but this is good for things like where baby shrimp, you know, they are kind of stationary when they are small. This stuff spreads all around the tank. If I go a little bit lower down, you might just be able to see the little plume of food that's coming off this. Here in Norway in the summertime, the lakes are literally covered in the surface of pine pollen, okay? This stuff I have here is from flowers that grow in mountainous parts of the world. You can see that plume there. Now this is one of the things I don't advise you to do. If you're going to put a few pieces of this in, and you're going to stand and watch them, use a feeding dish. Right, if it's just before lights out, you don't bother, just put it anywhere in the tank. But today, because I want you to see them on it, I'm going to use a feeding dish, okay? So I'm going to put a piece in every part of the tank. We're going to go to the music, etc., because I know you guys love that. I love it myself. I love editing those parts. So it'll be one momento. Thank you. what's happened already because I've been through here all the time. But that would kill the suspense, wouldn't it? That would kill the suspense. Now what you will find with pollen is if you put it in dishes as well, as most of the time it will just dissipate and you will never see anything else of it. It will be in the water column, it'll be floating around, it will go in sponges, etc., like these big fellas. And the one over here, you can just see past that lovely glare. Here's a good example of it. You were just watching the video less than a few minutes ago, and this had pollen in it. It's all gone. But the shrimp still know the food is in the water, and it's dispersed everywhere in the tank, and this is evident by, when you look at the floor, they are literally everywhere. And they're still looking for food. Look at this beautiful female here. What's this called, guys? Stop sign CRS. Isn't it gorgeous? Look at three spot on his back. Beautiful shrimp. Everywhere looking here, they are searching for food. I've taken video of different parts of the tank as well, just to show you the difference in the spreading of the pollen, so to speak. And it goes to every corner of the tank. Any filter that's in here will suck it into the sponge as well. Oh, hello! Okay, so pollen is a highly, highly recommended food. I would use it at least a few times a week, at least anyway. For me, because I have so much of it here, I tend to use it at least every second day. If I don't use, I'll just show you guys what else I use. And this is not an advert, trust me, this is not an advert. I use Pure Nordic's NutriDust, that's one of them. And I use my own pollen mix. This is available in my store. My store has had a refurb as well. I no longer use the one on WordPress. I have a dedicated website now for, and the store part of my website, if that makes sense. When you click on the link on my blog part of my website, it will take you to another website that is a proper shop, okay? So go check that out. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. Please give me a like if you enjoy this kind of thing. You want to see more. And I'll see you in the next one, okay? Happy shrimp game, guys.